Okay, now go.
Okay, in the Brahmins Masters, ages 45 through 49, in first place we have Ken Bray.
That's me. All right. Only one day after the old school Iron Gym Summer Showdown, I get an email from Gregory Page, director of the USAPL Pro Raw Deadlift Challenge at the 2015 Great Lakes Sports Festival in Erie, Pennsylvania, inviting me to compete. It was a no weight class, deadlift only, battle for cash. And it was in 1 month. I remember thinking to myself,
fuck yeah, where do I sign up?
Yeah. What? I'm digging that. What? Are you? What? Well, let's ride out. What would you do? The deadlift is arguably the purest of all the lifts. There are no hacks, no cheats, no shortcuts. Either you make the lift or you don't. It's just you against gravity. And there's nowhere to hide.
Enough. The weigh-in tomorrow is at 11, so I'm gonna shoot to leave out at about 7:30. Okie dokie. I
really shouldn't have been laughing at my mother and her old school expressions that night, because karma is a bitch. And that next morning, oh, the creek rose all right. Finally, ready to go. Only 15 minutes late.
Hang your fingernails?
I gotta do so.
So, tell me about nuts.
Erie, Pennsylvania, it's only about 100 miles away, which amounts to a drive of a little less than 2 hours, which isn't that big of a deal, except I haven't been in a car with my mom this long since I was first learning how to drive 30 years ago. But apparently, some things never change.
In a quarter mile, use the right lane to take the I-271 North US 422 West ramp to Erie, Pennsylvania.
Erie, here we come!
Continue on I-271 North for 11 miles.
Despite a little bit of digestive enthusiasm and passenger seat heckling, the mission was going pretty smoothly. But as the great poet Robert Burns once said, Even the best laid plans of mice and men often go awry.
Oh, I didn't bring my wallet.
For real?
This in my jeans, sitting on my bed.
Okay. Honey's getting money from the dummies in the club, say. Okay. Bouncing that ass, hit that dub, say.
Keep it on the low, low. Put the low pole, pull a nigga over. And tow the rodeo. Go down the Honda. Hide that endo. Don't let them see that too.
Anything else I need to grab? Back in a minute. All right. Now we're ready to go. Maybe.
We can't turn back the time. You know that, don't you?
Sure we can.
How many G's can you withstand?
That crazy son of a bitch tie got me high while I'm trying to drive. Chronic contact high. Get me one from the track. Till a 32 a Gatorade. Ghetto lemonade. It done got into my cranium. And I'm hallucinating. Thinking I'm seeing niggas swinging from trees like fruit vests. Watch that. Ghetto lie. I can't even cross that. Best be believing that chronic. It got my heart to beating rapidly. And I ain't even choking. That nigga die smoking. Give me a sandwich before I eat my fucking car battery. I got the munchies. And that food just happened. Too much of that death fun. Make the cops be like, damn, son. Get out the car, let me check my guns. Better yet, let me check you once. Don't let me get to acting disorderly before Wappy. Locked in Chatham County till Monday. Cause you know you can't post no bail at the 5 on a Friday. Why? Expect these speed limit signs to slow me down. I'm 50 in the 30. I'm kind of worried.
Hi, for competitors, do we need to sign in here or we just go in?
With who?
USAPL powerlifting.
Powerlifting, and just see if we have the right vendors, arm wrestling.
USAPL right here?
Powerlifting, here's one.
There I am, right up top.
Okay, Ken Bray. I was just looking to see if we had more of those. And I'm sorry, your name?
Ken Bray, right up top.
So that gets, you're the staff or you're a competitor?
I hope I'm a competitor. I may have to buy you a ticket. $35. You need to lift too. You carry my bags. You have a veteran's discount, do you?
No.
Senior citizen discount? Out of towners discount? Yeah. Red t-shirt discount? Sunglasses discount? Nothing. All right.
The Great Lakes Sports Festival is a regional event showcasing athletes in a wide range of fitness-related disciplines. There was CrossFit, bodybuilding, strongman, arm wrestling, and of course, powerlifting.
You ready? Well, you gonna be on the movie now.
I saw you go past me on the freeway.
Really?
Yeah.
How'd you know it was me?
Right? Ken Bray. I was like, hey, it must be Ken Bray.
You ready? Ready to do this thing?
Yeah.
See how it goes,
yeah,
man.
Why not?
Ready to be in chapter 5-6?
Oh,
okay. Oh, yeah.
Fair enough.
Oh, wait. You're the enemy now.
The Deadlift Invitational is a unique competition that pits the 8 best male and 3 best female deadlifters in the region against each other in a winner-take-all show of absolute power, with the victor to be determined by Wilk's score. When it comes to getting ready, each athlete has his or her own warm-up philosophy. Some lift a little,
Some lift a lot, and some lift a whole lot. Me? I just take in the moment and wait my turn. Since this was only 3 rounds of deadlift, with no bench press or squat to save your ass, everybody brought the thunder. Is a place in the order of the weight that they are lifting. My opening lift of 561 pounds, the heaviest I'd ever opened with, put me 9th in line. That successful opening lift automatically put me ahead of all the men in front of me. Problem was, there were 2 men behind me, and they were lifting more.
Go. Go.
Ever hear the story of David and Goliath? Things got interesting in a hurry in round 2. Strategies were being tested, and athletes were already jumping positions in the lifting order, all vying for first place. Some successful, and some not so much. Tanks were already beginning to empty.
Hold on, hold on.
The bar's loaded.
My strategy? Simple. Step up to the bar. Get a firm grip, take a deep breath, and do that thing that I came here for. That thing that I wake up in the morning for. That thing that I stay awake at night for. That thing that I train for. That I sacrifice for. That I travel the country for. That I would risk my life for. Lift the fucking 6. Yeah. And just like that, I am no longer chasing 600. In training, I've become quite used to outlifting men who outweigh me by quite a bit. But in competition, I normally only compete against men in my own weight class. But on this day, this man, Zach Gallman, who outweighs me by nearly 100 pounds, stands between me and first place.
and he just lifted 661 pounds like it was nothing. My successful lift in round two left me completely emotionally and physically exhausted. So I requested the league minimum increase in weight of 606 pounds. But honestly, I had missed a lift before I even stepped up to the bar.
The lift is no good for Ken.
With that miss, my fate was in Zach's hands. I was currently in the lead coming out of round two, and in order to beat me with the Wilk scoring, Zach would have to lift in excess of 700 pounds. So David defeated Goliath with a sling and a 600-pound stone. Without a sword in his hand, he struck down the mighty giant.
Second place, Zach Goldman.
Zach, big man.
And first place, with 184 Wilkes points, Ken Bray.
What?
It was a good day that day in Erie. I won a new award. I set a new record. And I was finally able to get that 600-pound gorilla off my back. And it also didn't hurt that I got paid to do it.